your young ladies and your young men, some of you are graduating this year, some of you are graduating next year. You can no longer blame anything on your parents. Because as parents, all we can do is all we can do, and all we can do is enough. That's it. Right or wrong?
Right.
And if you don't want to be teachable and coachable, then you're going to go out and life is going to tell you some things. See, my husband and I appreciate everybody letting me talk because I like to talk, but speaking is something I'm passionate about because my business mentor, when my husband and I decided, you know what, we just got to be able to give back more. I've always been a giving person, but when I worked a job, I couldn't give to a person that didn't work at the company I did because they didn't work at the company I did. So I believe if you give with limitations, you're blessed with limitations. And I want all my blessings. That's what made my husband and I go into owning our own business. Oh, it's hard work. I hear people all day say, I want to be a boss. Being a boss is not about bossing somebody around or tearing somebody down. It's about lifting somebody up. See, if you need your title or your position to define you, you're a sad person and you will always be miserable because somebody will always have to validate you. But my business mentor heard me at one speaking engagement. There are people that were kind of, you know, women were coming to me and they're like, wow, you know, you just got it. And I always want people to know, I don't have anything you don't have. All of us have a gift. But my business mentor is the one that told me about mine. Because remember, I told you when I was coming up, my talking was so negative. And she heard me talk. And I was one of those ones that for years, I would cry when I was alone. And I would say, God forgot me. Because everybody had a gift. My husband had track. You know, even though he didn't go into that, you know, field, he still found one of his purposes. You know, one of our daughters can draw, you know, my son, he's like the technology guru, and my second daughter, she's our actress, the one that always wants to put a smile on your face. But me, I just felt like I was lost. And then my business mentor heard me speak, and she said, you ever thought about being a motivational speaker? She said, because when you speak, you speak in a way I have never spoken. Like she's never heard anybody speak. And I felt good about myself. I said, wow. It took a stranger to tell me something positive than anybody could have told me. But when people don't know, then all they can do is lead you only so far. You have to dare to be around people better than you. That's one of the things we learn in business. The people that you see now, it's all the different business mentors and people that we allow to mentor in our life. Because if you have an ego, we call it edging God out. You'll never get anywhere because you'll always want to be around people. And if you're the smartest person in your circle, there's something wrong with your circle. You know, when we sit down with people and a lot of our clients, we have some $1 million clients and we sit down with them, I can sit down with them and yeah, they may have millions of dollars in the bank now, but I always tell them, my check is in the bank, it's just waiting to be deposited. Because I never want anybody to believe they're better than me.